Student, today I give lecture on short term hydrothermal scheduling using gamma lambda iterations. Students, in this method the mathematical model is built slightly different from the other algorithm in terms of operating constraints. The first equations, the problem is defined. Minimize FT is nothing but the total cost, fuel cost of the thermal power plant, that is equal to summation of k equal to 1 to n HK cost of PGTK, that is equation number 1. In this equation, summation of k equal to 1 to n Q naught K HK equal to Q total. So this is the constant. Q naught K means water discharge in the kth time interval. HK means head in the kth interval. Q total is nothing but the total volume of water available for discharge. The equation 3 is nothing but the some constraints, that is the PD, demand plus losses minus thermal power generation minus hydro power generation, that is equal to 0. Again, the summation of k equal to 1 to n, that is water head in the kth time interval HK equal to maximum time interval T max. This is equation number 4. Now we are considering the constant head operation. Then the water discharge in the kth time interval Q naught K depends on the hydropower generation in the kth time interval PGHK. Now we have tried down the Lagrange function. So the Lagrangian function is given by the Lagrangian function equal to summation of k equal to 1 to n HKF PGTK plus lambda k into PDK plus P loss k minus PGTK minus PGHK plus gamma summation of k equal to 1 into HK into Q naught K into PGHK minus Q total. Okay, this is the equation number 5. Then the coordination equations, the equation 6 and 7 is called as a coordination equation. So therefore the dou Lagrangian transfer, that means the Lagrangian function divided by dou PGTK equal to HK differentiation of F into PGTK divided by differentiation of PGTK plus lambda K into dou P loss K divided by dou BGTK equal to lambda K only. Then the equation 7, partial fraction of Lagrange function with respect to hydropower generation in the kth time interval equal to gamma into HK dQ naught K into PGHK divided by TPGHK plus lambda K into dou P loss K divided by dou PHK equal to lambda K. In the equation 7, the gamma convert incremental water rate to the incremental plant cost. The gamma is a constant value over the iterations unless the reservoir storage limits are violated. In the coordination equation 6 and 7, we have to neglect the losses. We get equation 8 and 10, that is HK differentiation of F into PGTK divided by differentiation of PGTK equal to lambda K. Then gamma HK into dQ naught K into PGHK divided by TPGHK equal to lambda K. Then the first one is, we studied about the gamma lambda iterative algorithm for short term hydrothermal scheduling. If you want to solve the coordination equations, that is 6 and 7, we neglecting losses means 7 and 8. Okay, now compute the first one is the differentiation of F into PGTK divided by differentiation of PGTK. So now we get the general cost function, that is the F of the thermal power plant, F into PGTK equal to AT plus BT BGT plus CT VGT squared. That is equation 10. This is the quadratic cost equation. I already told you F denoted for cost, P for power, G for generation, T for thermal plant, H for hydropower plant, K is the time interval, and then A, B, C is nothing but the constants. Okay. Then finally, the differentiation of F into PGTK divided by differentiation of PGTK equal to BT plus 2CT BGT. This is equation number 11. Now, what are the parameter to compute? The second one is DQ0K into PGHK divided by TPGHK. In this case, the water discharge in the kth time interval Q0K is the function of hydropower generation in the kth time interval PGHK. Now we are getting the equation 12 and 13 in the different parameter. One is the generation below some limit, another one is the generation above the limit. So therefore the Q0K equal to AH plus BH into BGH for generation below limit. Q0K equal to AH plus BH BGH into CT BGH squared for generation above the limit. Now you see the input output characteristics. Okay, so the input and then the output. Therefore input is nothing but water only. It is the Q0. Output is nothing but the power generation, that is the PGH. Okay, so therefore you can know the input is nothing but the water discharge, that is the Q0 meter cube per hour, and then the output is the power generation in the hydropower plant PGH in megawatt. You can draw. Now we get the shape of the curve is the parabola like this. So therefore the DQ0K into PGHK divided by T DPGHK equal to BH. If we are using the equation 12, what are the equation 12? That is the generation below some limit. Suppose we can use the equations, that means 13 means what is the equations, that means DQ0 into PGHK equal to DPGHK equal to BH into 2CHPGH. If equation 13, that is the for generation above the limit. Now, if you can consider the losses, then the power loss in the kth time interval P loss K equal to BTT BGTK squared plus 2BTH BGH power K BT power K and then BHS BGH power K the whole square. So therefore the dou P loss K divided by dou PGTK equal to 2BDT PGTK plus 2BTH PGHK is equation number 16. Then dou P loss K equal to dou PGHK equal to 2BHH PGHK plus 2BTH BGTK 17. In this equations 16 and 17, I mean, the BDT, BHH, BTH is the loss coefficients for thermal power plant and hydro power plant. The next algorithm step, we know the algorithm step, then only you can draw the flowchart. The first step, choose set 1, that means tolerance for power mismatch. Then set 2 is nothing but the tolerance power, tolerance for water discharge. So then next, first initial value, what is the initial value? Gamma and lambda k. Okay, then in this case initially all the generations are 0 only, that is arbitrary value only. So now we have to set k equal to 1 for the first time interval. Then you can calculate the power generation for the thermal power plant in the kth time interval BGTK using the equations 5. Now you can substitute the equations 11 and 16 into the equation 5. Now we are getting the equation 18. The equation 18 only is used to calculate the thermal power generation in the kth time interval BGTK, which is shown in the equation 18. Okay, then the fifth one is the calculate the hydropower generation in the kth time interval PGHK. In this case, the equation 6 and 7 is called as a coordinated equation. Now you can substitute equation 12. 12 is nothing but the for generation below the limit, and 17th equation to get, you are get the equation 19. That means for hydro power generation in the kth time interval PGHK only. In this equation la BHH, BTH and then BTT is the last coefficient of hydro and thermal power plant only. And then gamma is the incremental rate of the water. And then H for the head, K for the time interval. Okay. Then next, sixth step of the algorithm is del, that is the PK, that is equal to, this is the power deviation. Del is the deviation. The power deviation in the kth time interval, del PK called as a power deviation. The equation PDK plus PLossK minus PGTK minus PGH. That is the PD demand plus loss. PLoss minus thermal power generation minus hydro power generation. That is equation 20. In this case, the power deviation, modulus of power, only magnitude of the power deviation, suppose greater than set 1. Set 1 means tolerance for power mismatch. Then the lambda k equal to lambda k plus del lambda k. That is the deviation of lambda k. Suppose the modulus of, that means that is the pk, that value, that means suppose that means positive value. Of positive, suppose positive value of del lambda k means if the del pk greater than 0. Suppose the negative value of the del lambda, that means k, means the del pk greater than 0. That, sorry, less than 0. That is, go to step. One is positive value, another one is depending upon the positive and negative value of a del lambda k, we are getting the power deviation in the kth time interval del pk. That means either greater than 0 for positive value, and positive value del lambda k, and then less than 0 for negative value del lambda k. Then next, seventh algorithm step. Suppose, that means the modulus of power deviation less than or equal to set 1, that is the power balance. So therefore calculate Q naught using equation 12 and 13 only. So there, check if K equal to N, last interval means okay. Then you can next step, come to ninth step. If not means K is not equal to N means, sorry, if the K equal to N means, come, if K not equal to N means, then the K is incremented by 1. That is K equal to K plus 1. Then go to step 4. What are the step 4? Calculate, that means PGTK. Okay. Then the ninth step of the algorithm is, once the Q naught K computed for the K equal to 1 to N, then we are check some decision. Del Q, that is nothing but the modulus of summation of K equal to 1 to N Q naught K into HK minus Q total modulus, that is equal to less than or equal to set 2. Set 2 means for the tolerance water discharge. So the Q total is nothing but the total volume of water available for discharge only. So now if the decision is yes means stop, the algorithm is stopped, the full scheduling is stop. That is the hydrothermal study using a gamma, that is the lambda iteration stop. Otherwise, that means if no means what happen, if the del gamma is positive, del Q is positive. If the del gamma is negative, the del Q also negative. Then again go to step 4. 4 means del BGTH can calculated. Then this loop is keep on continuing for gamma and then lambda. Okay. Then unit del P, that is the deviation of power and the deviation of water discharge del Q have converged. This is the 12 algorithm steps. Now you see the flow chart. What are the 12 steps? First, select initial value in the flow chart for gamma and then lambda iterations. So first select initial values, then set time interval k equal to 1. Then next, that means you can solve thermal power generation in the kth time interval and hydro power generation in the kth time interval, that is PGTK and then PGHK respectively in the equation 19 and 20. Finally, we calculate the power loss, P loss. Then again, you calculate the power deviation in the kth time interval del PK with using the formula. Then again you have to check the modulus of power deviation is less than or equal to set 1. Set 1 means tolerance for power mismatch. If no means lambda k equal to lambda k plus del lambda k. Otherwise if yes means find the water discharge in the kth time interval Q naught K. Okay, then next if K equal to N, last interval. If no means the interval is incremented, that is K equal to K plus 1, again go to step 4. 4 means solve PGTK, PGHK and power loss. Okay, if yes means, if K equal to N, yes means, then go to the step, you can calculate the deviation of water flow, that is a del Q, that is equal to summation of K equal to 1 to N into Q naught K into HK minus Q total. Then again you are asking the modulus of del Q, that means less than or equal to, that is the set 1, okay, N means output schedule. If no means the gamma, that means equal to gamma plus the change in the gamma, that is del gamma. Again the loop will go to step 4 only. That means 4 means PGT, solve PGTK and then PGHK from equations 19 and 20 respectively and calculate the power loss, P loss. Okay, students, in this lecture video, I hope you clearly understand the short term hydrothermal scheduling using gamma lambda iterations. Okay, so first you write the objective function power constant, that equations, then gamma lambda, that is the iteration algorithm, then algorithm steps, then flow chart. Okay, so this fully equations only, up to, that means 20 equations, you can write down the equation, draw the flow chart, write down the steps. So it comes under this topic, how the question will come in the VTU examination. Deduce or derive the expression for the hydrothermal scheduling algorithm using gamma lambda iterations. Thank you students for watching this video.